Good morning, one and all. Today we are going to start with a new topic. Last class we have seen some of the challenges. Okay, so now today's topic, whatever we have, so here we are going to expand all the requirements driving towards a specific architectural changes, whatever is happening for IoT. So from this slide, you can get, from today's class, you can get the question like what all are the requirements driving will be there to expand the architectural changes for IoT. Okay, so you have to mention some 5 points and then you are going to discuss about the 5 points. So the first point is scale. Okay, so that is the first point. Second point will be security. That also I will show you. Third point will be constraint devices and networks. And fourth point will be data. And the last point will be legacy device support. So for this question, you have to mention all the points and then you are going to discuss or you're going to write the more points about this. Because you can see my slide, I have put all the points because this question carries your 8 or 10 marks of 10 marks. So you need to write properly and you're going to highlight your points. So today's class, I will be able to discuss only 2 points, that is scale and security. Another 3 points, we will discuss it in the next class. Okay. So starting with the expand form of your requirements, which is driving the specific architectural changes for IT, the very first point will be your scale. So now we have to understand what you mean by scale. Okay. So you people know that scale, generally we are going to talk about the IT networks, okay, where there will be connected with the thousands of devices. Fine. Just try to understand the meaning of your scale like a story so that whenever you will write the answers, you have to put your own technical words and you're going to elaborate it properly. Otherwise, you won't get to know that what you supposed to write for this scale, okay? So whenever we are discussing about the scale, that time we have to consider the IT network. Why we are considering the IT network? Because it has to be connected with 1,000 devices. So what all are the varieties of 1,000 devices? It can be your printer, it can be your mobile wireless devices, it can be your laptop, it can be your server, or it can be anything, okay? That is your first point where we are going to give the connection in between your 1,000 devices. What is the next point comes? Whenever we will have some kind of your devices, we should have the connectivity among them, right? So here what we are going to do is, we should have the traditional 3-layer campus networking model. That is nothing but, it is just the connectivity among all the devices. So here we are going to provide the 3-layer networking model, okay? So this also will help you to support all the varieties of access and the distribution of network so that it can reach in all the devices properly. Fine. Suppose sometimes what will happen is, like when the scale of a network goes from a few thousand endpoints to a few million endpoints, that time how you are going to measure the scale? That is the first question arises whenever we will give the connectivity among all the devices. And again, one more also question may arise, like how many IT engineers we need to design this kind of the networks, okay? Because here we have to support the millions of networking endpoints. So how many IT engineers we supposed to, it's required to design the networks, okay? So these kind of questions will arise whenever we will start give the connectivity. Fine. So here what will happen is, suppose this kind, whatever we have written, all these things will be under your tier one service providers. That we have to remember, because tier one service providers has already been implemented this kind of activity. So here, what's the extra IoT is going to introduce? Here, the IoT will introduce that how the the size, what will be the size of the factory, and how it is going to give the connectivity among them, and how the transportation system will be. Okay, all these things is going to give the connectivity. Fine. So once again, here you can see that we can easily find out the network system, and we can support all this network system, and we can have the scale on this. So based on your scale requirement, sometimes what happens is the IPv6 will be under your IoT network layer. So here, if you want to find out the scale requirement for a specific IT network, you should have the connectivity on your IPv6, okay, which is also known as the foundation of your IoT network layer. So through that, you can find out the requirements and you can solve the problems. So in this way, your IoT is going to enhance the scale in an expanded form for the in terms of your architectures. So this is all about your scale. Moving towards the next slide, you can see here, I told you the next point, that is your security. So security, normally, if we will see the word, we can understand that we are going to protect our network from some malicious attacks, right? So how we are going to protect it? So to say it's very easy word that yes, we are going to protect. But how many layers of protections you can give, how you can there will be many data hackers, or there will be many cyber hackers will be there. So how you are going to protect your network? Okay, so here you can see you need to write about the security more, because there will be more points under your security. Fine. So here the thing is that the first thing is we have to protect our networks, machines and all this from the malicious attacks. Okay, those who will be using the vulnerabilities. And how you are going to protect, they will be having the frequency, they will be having some impact factor from many years, so that once they have done with that, they can increase it, the impact factors and frequency to have the cyber attacks. So how you can protect all these things by using the IoT network. Okay, so if we will discuss, I told you that all these things we have to discuss by taking the example of our IT networks. Okay, so here if I'm taking any corporate datas and all, and suppose if the theft happened, so what will be the first thing, or what will be the first function, which one is going to get hampered? So here what will happen is, in our IT departments, we know that there will be many servers, many applications, and many networking systems which is running at a time, right? So we have to design the security in such a way that where we can give the protections to the IT departments. So if you want to protect the the networks and all, so the first thing is we should have the trusted network. Okay, how we can believe that yes, the network whatever we are penetrating, that is a trusted network? It has to defend the firewall. Okay, we should have the perimeter of firewall where it can defend through that, and we can think we can think over that, yeah, outside of the firewall there should not be anything where our data will go wrong. Okay, so that is the first thing we should have, that we should get the trusted networks. Okay, what is the next point? How we are going to, the next point will be in our IoT, all these IoT endpoints and all, they will be having the wireless sensor network. Okay, so if they have the wireless sensor network, in most of the companies, they won't be having the licensed version. So if it is not there, the license spectrum and all. So the first thing is we should analyze the problem, and we should have the licensed version of all the system, networking system, whatever we are using, any softwares, any applications, it should be a licensed version. Okay. So if we will have that, then definitely with the IoT, by using the IoT endpoints, the data, whatever is getting shared, it won't be get affected. And also if we will take the OT systems, okay? So OT systems, you know, already I have discussed about that, where it will be connected with all the varieties of your IP networks, and also it will have some capabilities to increase the potentials of your vulnerability. So here what will happen is, once you have got connected with your IP networks, you will get the IT security, okay? So once you will get your IT security, then definitely you know that IT security is different and we are having the OT system is different. So if we will merge all the traditional models of your IT security with our OT system, and with that, if we will add some kind of your layers of security, then definitely we can protect all these security problems by using the IoT, okay? And also this IoT system, why it has come into the picture is because it is having the mechanism of your authentication. You people are doing many projects and all. So you know that first thing is we should give for the authentication. There are many varieties of authentication are given. So why it has come, as IoT is providing this kind of mechanism, that is the reason we have merged together to get the proper security. This IoT, what all are the things it's giving, it's providing? It's providing the authentications, it's providing the encryption and decryption techniques, and it provides the intrusion prevention techniques and all, okay? So what, how it's going to understand that, that yes, in these industrial protocols, there will be a like attack, which is like, it can respond with the attacks and all. So it's have its inbuilt functions where it can find out the critical issues and it can find out, it can respond towards all the varieties of your attacks because of your authentication, encryption, decryption, and all the variety of prevention techniques. So these things and all your IoT supports. So you have to highlight all these points clearly so that you can, like while writing, you can elaborate this point where it will have some marks. Moving towards again, so if we want to discuss about some optimum security, okay? So in our optimum security, what are the things the IoT system should have? So the first thing is it should identify and it has to authenticate all the IoT services, okay? That is the first thing. So if the IoT system cannot identify and cannot authenticate the IoT services, then what is the use? We cannot say that we are providing the security and that to optimum security. So it has to identify and authenticate all the IoT services. So what all are the IoT services are there? It can be your gateways, it can be your endpoint devices, it can be your home networks, it can be your roaming networks, it can be your service platforms. So these are some of the examples of your IoT services where the IoT system has to identify and authenticate. Okay, that is the first point of your security. Moving towards the second point, what we should have, why we are using this IoT, because we want to share the data in between the endpoint system. So whenever we will send the data in between the endpoint devices, that time the backend applications, whatever is running, it has to be encrypted. So when the data will reach into the another endpoint, that time it can be decrypted easily. So that is the second point which you, if you want to if you want to have the security, you should provide it. What will be the third point about this? The third point will be, it has to provide with the local data protections, which can be stored correctly and protect properly. So here how we are going to, if we cannot save all the data, or if you cannot keep all the data in a protected way, then any time the data can be hacked. So that will be your third point where we have to store all the data properly. So these all are your three points. Moving towards the fourth point, so we will see about the IoT connectivity, where and how it is providing through the management platform. and how all the rules has been established to provide the security. So this IoT connectivity will have some rules and regulations and some kind of your policies where it has to take the immediate actions if it will see some some kind of your attacks on any connected devices, or if it can find out or if it can detect any kind of your some mischievous behavior, then it what kind of actions it has to take immediately, that policies has been written inside your IoT system. So that is your fourth point. What will be the, again, one more point, that is the last point. Here for the security, the IoT system has to provide the network level approach, because here the IoT system has connected with all the thousands of endpoints by using the networks. There will be a variety of networks. It can be your distributed network, it can be your a peer-to-peer network, it can be anything. So it's going to connect all these things by the help of your network. That is the reason here we should provide the security in terms of your network level approach. So these are some points where we can have the optimum security by using the IoT system. So the points are very clear. While writing, you have to keep in mind that how you are going to write the points. Because first thing, I have discussed about the identification and authenticity. Then I discussed about the encryption of data sharing. Then I discussed about the protection and storing procedure of all the data. Then I discussed about the IoT connectivity. And the last I discussed about the network level approach. So here all these things you have to take care properly. I'll just highlight these points you have to remember. The first one will be your identification and authentication. Next one, you are going to share all the data, okay? And next, how you are going to protect and store the data, okay? And the next one, you are going to talk about your IoT connectivity. And the last one, you are going to talk about your network level approach. So these are the points which has been highlighted. You have to remember, and while writing, you have to write it properly, okay? I hope you have understood this. Next, moving towards the next slide. This is the next point, actually, that is your constraint devices and networks. Let me discuss about this point also. So what happens here is the constraint devices and the networks. So it will be having with your IoT, it is going to work with your IoT sensors. So here in IoT sensors, all these things has been designed in such a way that where we can we are going to act on a single job, okay? And if you know that if we will act on a single job, then definitely it will be expensive, okay? And yeah, if it is a very small things and all, then what will happen? Maybe it won't be that much of expensive, but we should spend the time for all the single design job, right? So it will take the same kind of your power, CPU and memory. Okay, and while transmitting from one place to another place. So how the IoT sensors, IoT sensors has designed in such a way that where only it can work on a single job. Why we are doing like this? Because it has to be very proper, and it can act only, because if we will give the more job and if the IoT sensors will not provide at a time to do the multiple jobs, then there will be a failure, right? So to avoid all these things, we will assign the IoT sensors to a single job, and we will design that IoT sensor in such a way that it will be very small and it will not be that much of expensive, okay? And also it will use a limited power and CPU and memory things while transmitting the data. Then what will happen? Then we can assign the small IoT sensors for different jobs. It will be easy for us also. And it can provide, it has to design in such a way that where it has to provide the low data rates, okay? So that if we won't have the proper connectivity also, it will be able to transfer all the lossy data bits and all. Fine. So there will be many different situations of you will be there for your IT networks when we can enjoy with the multi gigabit connection speeds and with the powerful endpoints and with the CPUs and all. But some places will be there where there will be no signals at all. So that time how the IoT sensors will work. So it has to design in such a way that it will be, it can act in any of these situations, okay? So that is the reason to increase the performance, we have upgraded to a faster network, okay? So here how we can upgrade to the faster networks, we have checked it out and we have connected with all the varieties of scaling purpose with the IoT systems where it can get the higher level of your scale where it can meet with all the technologies and it can provide you the scale and the constraints, all these things. So here we have to upgrade always the devices and the IoT sensors and all. Okay, so this is about your constraints, like devices and network. So with this, the next class, we will see about the data, how it is going to work and all. So to remember this slide, the major points, whatever I have seen, so here you have to make the IoT sensors first thing. It has to be designed only with a single job, okay? If we will do like that, then definitely we will have the small, we are going to spend only small and inexpensive. It will be very inexpensive, fine. And also it will have the limited power things and all. And also you can have like memory things and all will be very small. Next thing will be you are going to increase the performance constraints. How you are going to do that? You are going to upgrade your network. That is the first thing, okay, that you have to remember. So if you are going to upgrade it, then definitely it is going to impact on the performance. It is going to impact the performance where you can increase your scale. Where you can increase your scale. So these things and all are the major points which you need to write while writing the answers. If we will have the proper connectivity, you can go for your scale and constraint limitations. So these are your major points. You can note it down also while writing this constraint devices and network. These points should be there. Then other things you can write down as per your own technical words, okay? So with this, I'll just wind up my class today and hope you people have understood. In the next class, we are going to see the data and the legacy device support, how it is working and all. So that two more points will be under your same question, okay? So that one will be the continuation of this class. Hope you people have understood. Thank you.